So the first thing I've done to get ready to show you the difference between plastic and stainless is I've taped the board in half. I'm going to do a plastic trial on the one half and a steel on the other. When you're using white and light colored plastics, even though this is the best trial you're ever going to get for doing Venetian, it's going to leave carbon deposits, and you'll see that. So let's get ourselves some white Grisello, because this is the most delicate of the plasters. On you. Alright. Then we'll put this one on the top. So we're going to do a typical traditional finish. Ooh, a little something in there. On you. Hard working in such a small area. There's more plastic. Ding dong. So, again, I'm not going for like a super technique at the moment. I just want to show you, well, we're going to do it right anyway, the difference between the two. And voila. All right. Now the plastic trowel. Now you'll notice several things. One, small pavon, stainless, small plastic. Trapezoidal shape, rectangular shape. Rectangular? Rectangular shape. Good board. All right. Rounded edges, non-rounded edges. Both have an amazing bevel. And that's very important. Blunt trowels are ones with the non-tapered, just throw it away. You want a tapered edge. Now that being said, this is going to take, there's a learning curve. This is a little bit different feel. It'll take you a little bit to get used to it. I used one of these when I was down at the International Monetary Fund in Washington, D.C. I had to do a soft-colored Marmorino, and the downside to that is the Marmorino, the aggregate, eats through these trowels, wears them down. Okay. So you're going to have to get used to that feel of it. But you already hear like the difference, no scraping sound. All right, that's that. We're going to let this dry 100%. I'm going to show you this each step of the process, because I want you to really see I'm not trying to play any games here, to just get you into another trial. So we're going to dry this, come back, step two. Dry. Okay, step two, stainless steel trial. A little bit of my. And here we go. This Grisello is such a nice plaster. Okay, come on now. Well, unfortunately, I don't have any white marks yet. It'll come in the burnish too. All right. Oh, yeah, white plaster, you got to be in a very, 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 very clean area. one lefty. Look at that. All right. Let it dry, come back. Varnish coat coming up next. That's what we're going to see in the blackish brown box. We're not dry. Okay, she's dry. Let's take a close look here. Sorry, I have to look off to the side to see what you can see. I zoomed it in. You can see right here, there's all these little black spots. See this? Okay, no good. No good. If you look down here, clean, pristine, and white. Beautiful. No good. Pretty. No bueno. Magnificent. Eek! Okay? Yeah. Dark spots all through it. Such a bummer. But that's why we had the plastic trowel. Beautiful plaster. Okay, so there you have it. The Pavon plastic trowel to prevent black carbon marks on your plaster. There'll be a link to purchase this in the description below. I'll have links down there for this one as well. This is a great trowel. It's just not so good for white plaster. My name is Ron Lehman. I'm from the Foes School in Frederick, Maryland, where I teach decorative painting workshops and complete commission projects for clients all around the world. If you're interested in classes or commissioning me or buying these trowels, you'll find links to everything in the description below the video, as well as links to anything else I could think of. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.